ain't got my goddamn headphones on.
But the piece de resistance. Still can't hear him. Ow!
Crash Bandicoot 2.
Crash Bandicoot 2. Cortex.
Alright, you ready for this?
Resist.
I woke up today, I was heated. Cortex got yeeted. He's about to get defeated if he messes with me.
Crystals.
Alright. I got heated, decided I would play some Crash 2, and there's nothing that's gonna stop me. So, that's what we're doing. I got time today. Slave crystals.
You fool! Do you think I'm unaware of the situation?
You think he's dumb?
I'm an enemy.
Crash? Crash! 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 Crash!
Easy. Alright, two fun facts right off the bat. One, where the fuck am I supposed to get a battery from? There's never been a battery in this whole fucking series. Secondly, I can't use a analog stick. Which is fine. I tried playing this with one of my friends a few weeks ago and couldn't handle it. But we're going for 100% here, baby! No joke. We'll see how well that goes. I'm no Crash expert, even though I just did this insane move right here. But yeah, that's the goal. Pray for me.
Well, well, well.
Well, well, well. If it isn't Crash Bandicoot, well,
that's me.
I apologize for the crude means used to bring you here, but I rather expect a written invitation would have been turned down. Surrounding you are a series of five doors. Through each door lies a well-hidden crystal. The crystals look like this. Bring me the crystals, Crash.
I'm glad he showed me. I probably wouldn't have found them.
For now. We will speak again.
Alright!
Crash Bandicoot 2.
So yeah, this game's kind of a pain in the ass. It's one of those, I really like how it's, they make it, you know, one of those games that's easy to enjoy, but hard to master. And I feel like they really nailed it because, and this one, you can play every level, you can blast through the whole game. It's not a challenge to beat the game. The challenge is getting 100%. Which can still be done in an afternoon if you're good. This is the perfect kind of game to get 100% on if you've never done it before. And I'll show you all the cool little tricks that I know. Oh yeah. Not like we need the lives, I can do it with one life. We do it with one life. Fuck the wildlife. I gotta have two wives by tonight. What a frightening sight. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, they're trying to trick me hardcore on this first level. What do they think? We're some fools? Freaking peacock. Get out of here. We're all about Paramount Plus around here. Damn, bursted my eardrum. See, it's a piece of cake. First level, no sweat. Could beat this level without even looking. I always like, too, how they have that relatively challenging bonus stage, and then they have this one. It's just like, there's no enemies. Just, if you know how to jump, you should be able to make it through. I don't think I've ever died in that bonus stage. Not to flex. as I continue to miss this simple jump here. Uh-oh. Yeah, go ahead and leave a dislike for that one. I apologize, that was my bad. Here's a little trick. Check this out. I'll try and do it both ways. Yeah, like, you're supposed to kill all those, but if you just jump through it. This is the kind of game, too, like, if you've never played it, then maybe you shouldn't watch this video, because it's more fun to figure it all out for yourself. But you can also watch it. I don't mind. Look at that. Alright. Now give me a real challenge, why don't you?
Crash, you've discovered a gem. Fuck the gems, Crash. We don't need those.
Well done, Crash.
Damn, he cut out. Alright, we're gonna go for the blue gem. Again, spoilers! Just skip to this time frame if you don't want to know the secrets of this level. If you want the blue gem... I always thought as a kid that you had to kill all the blue freaking armadillos or whatever. Turns out all you have to do is just not break any boxes. Spooky. And you have to spin the whole time. Don't forget to spin. No, that's not true. You are supposed to hit that turtle though. That's mandatory. That's why I've done it both times. What if I hit that box by accident right now after missing it like 20 times earlier? This is the tricky part. Oh, pray for me. Yeah, fuck these armadillos. Here's something that you shouldn't look up. Sonic's ass game? I guess that's what they, like, called the Crash Bandicoot 1 when they were making it. Yeah, I'm gonna fact check you. What's up, Sonic's ass game? So yeah, don't do that. But it's just because, you know, Sonic, the original Sonic trilogy was like left to right, but then Crash went like up and down. Whoa! Okay. This is like my favorite level in the whole game. Actually, we'll see. It's probably just because it's the second level that I always remember it. Great. You know what? I'm not even gonna finish what I was gonna say. Now I'm just pissed off. You know what? I don't even want this McChicken no more. Navy SEAL. Oh my! No, I'm not actually that mad. I probably will get pretty mad though. It's the kind of game that it's in the cards. Look at that. Freaking godly. Doing things you never thought you'd see. Oh, look at that. Oh yeah. Might as well call me Rob level, because I'm robbing this level of fruit. You guys actually know that he called himself Rob level because he's trying to rob you of information that everyone knows? Just kidding. Uh-oh. I got a notification on my phone the second day he said that. I was like, uh-oh. That's not good. No, he seems like a cool guy. Heck just happened? Did you see that? Check this out.
Ooh!
I heard that there's a leak out. I don't know if you guys have seen this, but Crash Bandicoot 5 has their, you know, calling it for right now. They're saying that they're trying to take every aspect that was fun with the original Crash Trilogy and taking it out of the game. I could be wrong, but I think maybe they should not do that. They did a pretty good job in Crash Bandicoot 4. Anyway.
Oh!
Look at that. I'm basically unfreaking stoppable. I always forgot where that was. There's like a little, there's a box up there if you just gotta hold X. Just gotta hold the sex button. I'm not going out of this level without getting one extra life. Just not gonna happen. Yep. And that's how we do it, ladies and gentlemen. Yep, I'm pretty much the greatest of all time. No, please calm down. You know, there's plenty of Crash to still go around. Just because I finished that level completely flawlessly doesn't mean, you know, there's still an opportunity for me to screw up at another point. Crash Bandicoot. Fuck. Crash Bandicoot 2. Oh, look at this. Speedrun guy! I actually have one of the, high scores for speedrunning. Just look it up. Yeah, look at this. Speedrun guy. I wish someone could stop me. They didn't, you know, they didn't account for this. They didn't account for this! Me being this good. I'm freaking unstoppable. I'm unbelievable. Andy Rubin himself said, he was scared to fight me. Because he's seen, seen my Crash Bandicoot skills. He said, I wouldn't fight that guy. I wouldn't do it. You know, I'd fight Mike Tyson, but I would not fight that guy. That guy with the speed run. He played the Hang 8 level. He got the frickin' gem with 38 seconds to spare. I would not mess with that guy. And I tweeted him back and I said, tweeted him an image of Sonic's ass. What the hell?
Three crystals. Not bad.
Thanks. See, Cortex isn't so bad. As long as you're not playing Crash Bandicoot 4. You can only beat this level with 17 lives. That's just the fact of it. Got X on my side. Check this out. Speed run. We're gonna just speed run it. Speed run. You know what? We might as well just put up the speed run of this level on screen. And you compare which one is faster. See, look at that. I jumped over the fish. Who else do you know in history who's ever done that? No one, because it's never happened. I'm the first person in history to ever do that. That wasn't even the way that the speedrunners would break those boxes. I just have so much time to spare that I just said, screw it, why not? No, see, that was part of my strategy. You're supposed to do that level wrong. No, yeah, see, and then you go back into it, and I'll show you exactly what, you know, other people... I was just showing you what other people would do. They're fools. It's a special cheat that when you have 17 lives, you can't die on this level. If that wasn't proof enough, then what else do I need to say? There's an Easter egg I heard. They liked X's 17 so much that they decided on Hang 8 that you wouldn't be able to die. Yeah, part of the problem was... I just skipped the bonus level, I think. Look at that. Oh yeah, all part of the strategy. This part's a pain in the cock. Look at that. Look at that. You seen that? Now look at this. Pretty much unstoppable. That's what they usually call me. Whoa! Check this out. Speedrun. Not even gonna try. I'm not even trying. Crowd going crazy because they know I'm just that freaking cool. Look at this. Some might, you know, think that took a lot out of me, but nah. Hardly even tried. The only issue is that I don't usually take that path. I go for the any percent run. So that's why I'm... No, a little sloppy around the edges, but only, you know, the keen speedrunning eye would be able to notice any mistakes that I've made so far this run. Yep. I'm pretty much the bomb diggy.